me to read it?
Go, Catherine.
I did.
Because your makeup looks
good. I know. But I know. I'm sorry.
Did you film it?
Yeah.
We got the wedding party to stop by just to see what we're doing this for, you know?
We're
pretty proud of it.
Okay,
that's done.
God damn.
I'm not gonna cry.
See you at the chapel. I love you, Scott.
I can't look at her because I'm gonna cry.
I know.
So she starts. I'm just gonna leave Terry.
So don't start, Sheila, because if you start,
I won't. Start. I won't.
Isn't that sweet?
Here.
Terry.
get in, Joan.
Doug.
Joan, get in.
Doug.
It's not blinking yet.
I'm crying.
Here, here's your job.
Doug, crack a joke. Come on, Doug. Doug, we need
you. I think I'm able to check water level.
No, I just
want to
see where the batteries go.
Keep water level high in base and check daily.
Okay.
Go location out of sun.
Where are those running water put these?
Chili Joe Scott.
Scott, where do you, I don't want it on the table. Honest to God, look at that.
Mom's
here to
chapel.
I love you, Scott.
Oh, Jim.
Jim did it.
It's not a big deal.
Jim did it. We'll put
it's
fine.
It goes away.
Let me put it out.
Put it out. It's not a lot of sun. Doug, what do you think? Where's we get married?
Check water level
and
add
warm
water.
No,
I know. Let's put
them
on my
grass.
The glass.
I just want you to all lean in
real
close together.
Everywhere.
Great. Okay. Let's see. Another one at grandma.
Doug, what are you doing?
What am I doing? Tug's getting all the after.
Some paper later.
I'll tell you what, why don't you wheel grandma down right there.
Okay. Maybe in front of Terry or?
Well, I'm gonna get her all by herself.
Oh, okay.
Grandma by herself?
Can we do this in the shade?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Watch your guys. Grandma by herself. They're getting one with Grandma by herself.
Oh, I want it. One with you.
We will.
We will.
He's getting one with her.
Shade.
Okay, well, turn you around your grandma. Gonna be the star attraction of the moment.
Okay.
Are we right here?
Yeah.
No,
that's
hot. That's nice. Is there something like right there poking me in the back?
Is it around here or over here?
I guess it was just the tag.
This was.
I know, but I
think you need an assistant.
Oh, like that. Real good. Looking here to me.
Pardon?
Do you need an assistant?
Well, I always do for everything.
It's that way.
Get on the smile, Jim.
Okay, that's nice. That's all right. Let's do it once more, real quick.
You use your stupid camera.
Once again, just like that. Great.
Right.
Okay. All right.
Oh, you're wonderful.
Now, you and your sister.
Yeah, but she isn't there yet.
Okay.
Yeah.
So she's going to be here.
Oh, so that's what she told me.
And then she said. You go over there.
Guys, but your coats.
Guys, but your coats.
You'll be hauling that big heavy lead thing around.
Mom, you don't have the footrest for Graham.
I know, she doesn't mind it.
Yeah. Doogie.
Doug, Dad. Is
it look at all the hard work on the yard.
Hello, Doug.
Hey, Doug.
Hi, Doug.
Hello, Doug.
We're here. This beautiful day.
Oh, my.
No. 30 years ago?
I guess I'm supposed to stand in the middle.
Yeah,
I
think that's
right. Well, we get you after.
All right.
I think we're thinking of you too.
Next to Mom? Or
no? Okay.
This way. Hey,
Mom, right. How do we look?
I'll tell you. Okay, like that. Good. Why don't you hold that bar? That's all right. You girls want to come way down here? I'm going to get the whole limousine in. That away. Okay, like that. Stay right there. Real good. I'll stay there a moment.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to St. Clement Church as we come together to witness the marriage of Scott and Carrie. I'd like to welcome all of you, and as we come together to celebrate the Eucharist and to witness their entry into marriage, we come with hearts filled with joy on their behalf. We join them now to ask Almighty God to strengthen them in their resolve as they enter married life. We begin this in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. As we join in celebrating the Eucharist, we pause first and call to mind our sins, asking the Lord's forgiveness. Lord, we have sinned against you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, show us your mercy and love, and grant us your salvation. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for Scott and Terry. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated for the first reading.
Thank you. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. It does not put on airs. It is not snobbish. Love is never rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not prone to anger. Neither does it brood over injuries. Love does not rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices with the truth. There is no limit to love's forbearance, to its trust, its hope, its power to endure. Love never fails. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Again, welcome to St. Clement Church. We gather this afternoon in response to Terry and Scott's invitation. They invited you because you're their loved ones, their family, and their friends. And this occasion surely would not be complete were it not for your presence. On your part, you can come because there's nowhere you would rather be than here with them now. I've had a lot of weddings in my day, but I don't think anybody's come from as far as Singapore. But we can claim that for this wedding and many, many other parts far and wide. It's a joyful day for all of the Garrett and the Bowers families because it is a very momentous occasion in the lives of their children, Scott and Terry. Probably the most important decision that they have thus far made in their lives, and I would say probably the most important decision they will ever have to make in their entire life, we have the privilege of witnessing at this moment. We've come together at this point to join them in prayer. We ask Almighty God to strengthen them, to enable them to be the best of spouses and the best of parents to the children that God may grant them. Later on in the day, we will be parting with them. But here and now, we've come together to join them in prayer. Very appropriately, at the foot of the altar of the Catholic Church, of course, is a symbol of Christ and his sacrifice of himself for our redemption. It is therefore a reminder to us of the love and the gratitude that should fill our hearts for the gift that Christ gives to us who accomplished our redemption. And there could be no more fitting beginning than for a young couple as they start their married life to begin it at the altar of the Lord, which is a reminder that where there is true love, there is sacrifice. We're told by St. John in his second letter that God so loved the world that he sent his only Son, and his Son so loved us that he gave himself for our redemption. We're reminded by that, that where there is true love, there is sacrifice. And therefore, very fittingly, Scott and Terry are reminded of the of sacrifice, that their love may not only endure, but grow deeper and stronger as we begin to go on. They've already experienced a great deal of love in their lives, the love of their parents and their grandparents, of their brothers and sisters, their aunts and uncles, their friends, their relatives. They've experienced a lot of love already. But today they come to celebrate that unique and special love that we call parental love. They have a good basis for this commitment because they have learned the meaning of love from their parents, from their friends, from those who have taken this step before them and have enriched each other in married life by the sacrifices that they've been willing to take upon themselves. The readings that we have just had are an interesting selection of readings. The first from the book of Genesis tells us the origin of marriage, the institution of marriage, when God gave Eve and Adam to each other and told them to increase and multiply and fill the earth. And in the second reading from Paul's letter to the Corinthians, the beautiful discourse on love, where St. Paul reminds all Christians, and in a very special way, this is applied to the of what are the ingredients of fostering and furthering their life of love together. Those of you And as you go in your lives, you have to bring all of these things forward out of love for each other. You have said to each other, I love you, in a lot of different ways. But probably most importantly, you've expressed your love by giving out this kind of patience, this kind of kindness, this kind of forgiveness and understanding of each other. What a beautiful love it is, Terry and Scott, to the two of you, as you and them are in your married life, as you make this kind of commitment to each other. And we pray today that Almighty God will enable the two of you always to live out these virtues in your life. God is very good.
Thank you. Praise.
his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When the supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory."
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith. When we eat his bread of life, and we drink his holy wine, we will pray your death on one till you come.
Father, call to mind the death of your Son endured for our salvation, his glorious resurrection and ascension into heaven, and ready to greet him when he comes again. We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering, and see the victim whose death has reconciled us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may be filled with this Holy Spirit and become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make us an everlasting gift to you and enable us to share the inheritance of your saints with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with the apostles, the martyrs, Saint Clement, and all your saints, on whose constant intercession we rely for help. Lord, may this sacrifice, which has made our peace with you, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Strengthen in faith and love your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Pope John Paul, our Bishop Justin, and all the bishops with the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Father, hear the prayers of the family you have gathered here before you. In mercy and love, unite all your children, wherever they may be. Welcome into your kingdom our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in your friendship. We hope to enjoy forever your glory through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come.
Grow him within and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit.
Keep us free from sin and protect us from all anxiety. So now make them one in love for each other. We ask this through Christ our Lord. God, the eternal Father, keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and be always in your home. Amen. May your children bless you, your friends console you, and all live in peace with you. May you always bear witness to the love of God in this world, so that the afflicted and the needy will find in you generous friends and welcome you with the joys of heaven. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
It is something of a custom in the Catholic Church that at the end of a wedding, the bride and groom place a little flower at the image of our Blessed Mother. Mary, as we all know, was selected by Almighty God from all eternity to become the one who would give flesh to his divine Son. We look upon Mary, therefore, as the example